Welcome to Hot Lead and Hardware, and I was today years old when I learned how to use go, no-go gauges without disassembling the bolt carrier. Stick around to find out how. Hit that like, subscribe, and notification button. Let's get into it. For anyone not familiar with the anatomy of the bolt carrier, the bolt has both an extractor and an ejector. There is an allowable tolerance between the bolt and the barrel when closing the bolt, known as headspace. They sell go, no-go gauges to test this. The go, no-go gauges look similar to rounds, but they are different lengths. So when you close the bolt, the go gauge should allow the lugs to lock in place, just like a typical round would. The no-go should not allow the bolt carrier to seat properly. If it does, you've got too much space, and this is dangerous.
So this is basically what we're trying to do. If you can see in there, there's the ejector, and there's what grabs the rim of the bullets for the casings when it comes in. Unfortunately, you can't just stick it under there because the ejector is going to throw the gauge right back out. So what we're trying to do is when we put the bolt in, we got to get the rim underneath that just before it goes into the chamber so the ejector doesn't have time to throw it out. So basically, it's kind of like this. So we get under and see how I'm under? And the ejector's compressed. Maybe you can see how it's got the rim. But the second I let go, it throws it back out. So most of the time when you're testing this, they want you to disassemble the bolt, take the ejector out, take everything out. That way it just sits in there nicely. That's great, but disassembling a bolt carrier like that is kind of a pain in the butt. So I found this was much easier.
I passed the go gauge through the ejection port while lowering the bolt carrier with my other hand. This allows me to apply pressure to the gauge until it enters the chamber. Some pressure on the back of the bolt is necessary to lock the lug. To remove the gauge, simply unseat the bolt, and the ejector will do its job, throwing the gauge free. I follow the same process with the no-go gauge. With the no-go gauge in place, the bolt carrier will not lock flush with the upper receiver. This is good and shows no excessive tolerance.
So I hope today's video was helpful. Please like, comment, subscribe, and ring that bell. This was a new format I was trying today that was a little shorter than normal for some of the more technical stuff. I know I don't like watching long videos to try and get to the point. So if you like this better, comment down below. If you like the backstories and all my mistakes, comment about that as well. I can honestly take some of my technical videos and do abridged versions, shorter versions for people that want it that way. But please let me know in the comments what you'd like me to do. I can change it up either way or do both. So again, thanks for watching and I'll talk to you later.